You and Sonny take this whole place down yourselves? Man, that's something. Sonny's gone ahead. Meet him back at the compound.
I need a gun for hire. You interested?
Let's do it. You can count on me.
Now go straight in. Sonny's waiting for you.
Come here, I got a good one for you. Geez, I sure hope you wasn't planning a vacation today.
I'm all ears.
Go to your bank up in the Bronx handles all that dirty laundry. So we're gonna walk right in, and we're gonna take whatever the hell we like.
Sonny.
Fuck 'em.
It's for you.
Link, you dodo. I'll be right back. Hang on.
Put the gun down.
Son, he's dead. Corleone's a history.
Don't hurt me! Oh. Don't hurt me!
Who you working for?
It was another family. I don't know who. They paid in full. All cash for the hit.
You know something. Otherwise, they'd have left you there.
Okay. I know that they were on their way to a club on the west side.
Get away!
Thank you.
Let me die. I must make peace with God.
Tell him what he wants to know.
I'll tell you, I'll tell you!
Who's pulling your strings, old man?
It's not my family you want. We are too weak. We carry the guns to battle, but do not pull the trigger. That is the job of the wolf, Don Barzini.
My wife is crying upstairs. I hear cars coming to the house. I Consigliere, man, I think you should tell your Don what everyone seems to know.
They shot Sonny on the causeway. He's dead.
I want all inquiries made. I want no acts of vengeance. I want you to arrange a meeting with the heads of the five families. This war stops now.
I must have a strict assurance from Corleone. As time goes by and his position becomes stronger, will he attempt any individual vendetta?
Look, we are all reasonable men here. We don't have to give assurances as if we were lawyers.
I'm willing to do whatever's necessary to find a peaceful solution to these problems. But I have selfish reasons. My youngest son was forced to leave this country because of his Salazzo business. All right. And I have to make arrangements to bring him back here safely, cleared of all these false charges. But I'm a superstitious man. And if some unlucky accident should befall him, then I'm going to blame some of the people in this room. And that I do not forgive. But that aside, let me say that I swear on the souls of my grandchildren that I will not be the one to break the peace that we've made here today.